So hello friends, in this video we will see why we use ng container if we have div tag inside HTML. So let's check with an example by creating a set interval method. So we have an array of type any. Let's add some data inside this array inside a constructor. So let's use a set interval. And for every 1 second, let's push some data inside the array. So we have to write array dot push date dot now dot to a string. So every 1 second, some data is added inside array. Now let's bind this array inside. So for binding we have to use ng for, and let's use ng for and let's some put condition like ng if data is not equal to empty, then it will be binded here. So as you can see, there is ng for, and inside ng for there is ng if. So let's check on browser. So as you can see, data is binded here, but I am not using ng container, I use only div. So as you, when you inspect that, and you can see for every element there are parent child element, this div, and there is another div inside the above div. So for every element there are two div are used. Just assume if we have lot of data, then there is large size of DOM on the page, so it will hang in some scenario if data will be large. So to reducing the extra div, we have to use ng container. So after using ng container, for every element there is only one div. So let's check by changing this div into ng container. Now let's check on the browser. So as you can see, data is added here, and you can see for every element there is only one div. So you can see it's reduced the size exactly half of the previous. So this is the benefit of using ng container in this scenario. Hope you like this. If you like this, please subscribe the channel, like the video. We'll back soon again with some other video.